son accepts a call from me. Help him, we pray, to learn humanity.
We're so proud of you.
Thanks, Mom.
Give him heaven, son.
I will, Dad.
Oh, I'll wait for you, I promise.
Me too.
I'll write you every day.
Me too. I'll see you in white. We've been planning this our whole lives, and here we are.
In the time that you were two and I was three, you were always the example.
What are best friends for?
I will be out there. Right behind you, man.
You promise?
Ah, Scout's honor.
You quit Scout.
I'll be there. I love you, man.
Godspeed, brother.
Spent the last 2 years on the Lord's errand. Now you're going to be getting back to your personal life, and that means dating. You're a handsome young man, Elder. And I encourage you to date.
Elder Phelps! Finally going home, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, you better stay true or I will hunt you down. I'm serious, I will. Peterson! Get to stepping!
But don't go overboard. Don't get greedy. I guess what I'm trying to say is, don't be an octopus with a testimony.
You don't need to worry, President. My girlfriend waited for me. We're planning on getting married.
Good for you, Elder. But remember this. By the sweat of your brow, you'll live your life.
My boss said I could have my old job back.
But never underestimate the value of an education.
My application to BYU is already in.
Well, Elder, that's superb. Sounds to me like you've got everything figured out.
Yeah. I've got a pretty good idea of how things will be.
Spent 2 years on the Lord's errand. You will be blessed for that service.
Yeah. I think it'll all begin at the airport.
And thank you for flying Emmett's disguise. I'm Skip. It's been a pleasure to serve you. Let's put that train cable up.
Best family ever!
Oh, you're so cute. Oh, you're so cute.
Elder Phelps?
Hi. Do I know you?
No, I was just reading your name badge.
Oh.
Can I sit down?
Okay.
Are you just getting home?
Yep.
You must have been a good missionary.
Well, we did a lot of walking, so...
Yeah.
So you hang out here a lot?
No. I'm picking up a friend. Can we give you a ride somewhere?
No. Thanks, but nah. My mom's probably picking up some balloons.
Hi, guys. Oh, hey, Trish. Trisha, this is Elder Phelps.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet both of you.
Well, we gotta go. Are you sure we can't give you a ride?
No. Well, yeah, I'm sure. No, thank you. Maybe another time.
Yeah, maybe. Okay, see you, Elder.
Supposed to go swimming.
Bad dog! Ow! Stop it! Get off of me!
When did they move?
Oh, about a month ago.
A month ago?
Oh, but you'll really like the Wongs. Such a nice family.
Jen!
We're in here!
Jared!
Oh, I was trying to get into what I thought was our house, and I got kung fu'd by some naked ninja.
I thought you told him.
We moved, sweetie. But what are you doing home from your mission?
Are you sick, pal?
No.
Are you still worthy?
Dad, I'm supposed to be home.
But your release date isn't for another month.
Mom, it's today. Didn't you get the itinerary?
Well, I do remember getting something.
Mom, you're pregnant! Nobody said anything about you being pregnant!
Hey, I didn't know until the visiting teachers called.
Oh, here it is. It was today.
Jared, let's have you meet our exchange student.
Oh, how exciting. Jared, this is Humu Humu Nuku Nuku Apu A'a. He's from Tonga. I told you all about him in the letter I sent last week.
I'm sure the mission home will forward it to me, Mom. It's nice to meet you, Homo Cookie.
We call him Humu for short. This is my son, Jared, the missionary.
Jared. He's home now.
Home. Me. Eh? Home. Me.
Hey, homie.
He speaks Tonganese. You boys look hungry. Let me get you a little something to eat. Oh, perfect.
Great to have you home, son. You're a great example to your brother and sister.
Hey, thanks, Dad. How are they doing?
Well, you know Moroni, not much of a letter writer, but he's having great success with the Lamanite people.
And Eve is just loving the MTC.
Where's everybody else?
Well, Soraya is no doubt with Dewey.
Oh, my lucky stars. That means you'll be here for the wedding.
Sam is at band practice. Ruth is at work. The twins are working on their service project. Alma and Amulek are at Cub Scout camp. Anyone else? Oh, Joseph. I haven't seen Joseph for days.
There's not much of a homecoming, I'm sorry to say.
Ah, it's all right.
Maybe Molly's will be better.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to getting over there.
Boys, look who's here.
Jared.
Hey.
You got sent home?
I'm supposed to be home. How you doing?
We got the dates mixed up.
Classic.
They check you guys out.
So, how's the project coming?
Good, Mom.
The twins almost have their eagles.
Mom's almost got our eagles.
Well, at least you guys won't get the no driver's license thing when you're 16, right? Hey, speaking of cars...
When did they sell my car?
I think it was after Moroni got his license suspended.
Eternal perspective. Eternal perspective. Guys, in the eternal perspective, the finer things of this world just don't matter. Okay?
Round brilliant on a platinum band.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. You planning on financing?
Cash.
Did you sell your car?
College. But I got a great job lined up.
Well, I'm sure she'll be thrilled.
Hi, Brother Spraggan.
Jared? What are you doing home?
I'm home!
This doesn't have anything to do with Molly, does it?
No, my 2 years are up.
Jared? What are you doing home?
I'm home.
Jared, it's not worth it. You should have at least finished.
I did finish.
But your mother said that...
I know. I'm home. I'm worthy. I'm here with you.
So when did she get back?
Today. What, you think I'd wait any longer to see the most beautiful girl whom I love more than anything in the world?
You didn't get the letter?
What letter?
Okay, I'm sorry, Jared. It's just that he got home 2 months ago, and we met at a Mason Mingle, and we started spending time together, and... Here's the announcement.
Oh, 2 weeks? His name's Kirby? What? You're that's not even a name.
Kirby is a fine name.
Rigby?
That's where he's from.
Kirby from Rigby likes to play frisbee.
Kate, you know what? I thought that you were gonna be a little bit more mature about this. I guess not.
So what? You're dumping me? To
marry a vacuum cleaner?
So, as your downline increases, so does your monthly income.
All from common household products we use every day.
Oh, hi, Jared.
What's going on?
We're having a little meeting.
Are you guys doing Nu Skin?
Jared, we don't use that word.
We're marketing LD3. Latter-day Discount Distributors! There is no reason a person can't earn $100,000 their first 6 months.
How long have you been at this? About a year.
Okie doker, let's see here. Then, according to my calculations, last year you should have earned about 200 large.
Not that much.
So what are we talking, low six figures?
Six figures would be full-time. We're part-time.
Okay, question. Let's see here. What about for a guy like me who has really cruddy self-esteem? What can I do part-time?
Well, I can tell you this. With the discounts on cleaning products alone, the money really adds up.
That sounds super.
Hey, hon. How was seeing Molly after 2 years?
She's engaged.
Oh, sweetie, I'm sorry. Her loss. Well, you know they say, trials make the heart grow stronger.
Mom, they don't say that.
Well, I do. Let me get you a cookie.
Mom, I don't want a cookie.
Brigham, Jared's girlfriend is engaged.
Hey, congratulations, pal.
No, not to him.
Hey, Jared, you know, my sister is coming back from her mission next week, and apparently with the tapeworm, she's dropped a lot of weight.
Huh.
I'm just saying.
I'll look into that. I'm going to bed. I got squashed tonight, bro. Totally dumped by the girl I love. You ever get dumped? It's like getting hit by a ton of bricks.
There, that should be much safer.
Thanks, Mom. Mom, this is food storage.
Oh, honey, we were running out of room, so we got a little creative. We're using the food storage as furniture, but don't worry, I made the cushions out of peanut butter and jelly MREs. Now, this should help your neck. Good night, honey.
Buddy, how are you? It's fine. Do you want some candy? Or some peaches? No, come back. Buddy.
Honey, it's okay. It's okay.
She started crying.
Joseph, this is your brother. He must not remember you very well. Oh, come on.
Ow.
Good morning. Those whole wheat muffins will help with your neck.
Thanks, Mom.
Jerry, so good to have you home.
Four more taxi in the house.
Yeah, it's a taxi with handlebars and pedals.
And an extra seat.
Oh, now, sweetheart, you should be very proud that our selling your car helped get Moroni on his mission.
Hey, Sam.
Good morning, Sam. How are you?
Hey, Sam.
Hey, we'll catch up later. Love you, Mom.
Bye. And besides, you can tell everyone that the spirit sits on back.
Do you see this, by the way?
Oh, no!
I know!
Hey, I'm glad to see at least one of us is in a successful relationship.
Oh, you'll find someone else. Of course, that's easy for me to say. I can't date yet, Mom.
And when you do, you'll have plenty of time to have your heart ripped out like your brother's.
All right, Ruth, we're late. Let's go. Bye. See you guys.
Good morning, Humu. There is plenty of food. Just sit up.
what have you got planned for your first full day home?
Well, I'm gonna go take the ring back, and then I gotta go see Brother Jensen about my old job.
Oh, good for you. Oh, you boys, you better hurry.
Have at it, bro.
Thanks, homie.
Hey! What happened to your neck?
Oh, a Tongan fell on me. I need to return this.
Need to be sized?
She didn't like it.
Oh, well, it's not big enough. Bring her in.
I don't think that's gonna happen.
Oh, we have flexible hours.
I really don't think that's possible.
She said no, didn't she? Well, I can't say I haven't seen this before.
Suckers, aren't we?
Amen, brother.
Oh, get this. She's marrying a guy named Kirby.
Kirby? It's not even a name.
I know, it's a dustbuster.
Yeah.
Oh, you should see the announcements.
Matching denim.
On bales of hay.
I've seen it time and time again.
Should have been my bale.
Oh, no. This one's on the house.
Hey, thanks. Well, I guess I better return that and get back to my life.
Oops, sorry. Store policy on diamonds is you have to exchange this for something else of equal value. No refunds.
I don't need a ring, though. I need money. I gotta go to college.
I thought you said you had a good job lined up.
Jared, what a surprise. Good to see you. I bet you're happy being home, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, I don't hear any painting going on in there. Jared, come in and have a seat. Make yourself at home. Julie, look who's here.
Jared, how nice. When did you get back?
Yesterday.
It's so good to see you.
Hey, Brother Jensen, I stopped by your office and some guy said you sold the company.
Jared, those guys didn't tell you. Sister Jensen and I, we started our new business.
Really? What is it?
UtahWeddings.com. You see, there are hundreds of websites out there to help members of the church meet. But once they do, then what?
Well, that's where we come in. We've partnered with HotSaints.com to not only get singles dating, but to get them marrying, too.
That's right, Wally. Once you know that special someone is that special someone, you leave the rest to UtahWeddings.com.
Amen, Julie. Our proposal packages include the ring and a variety of customized creative methods for popping that special question.
We even contact your priesthood leaders to schedule an interview.
It's amazing. So log on today and let UtahWeddings.com do the rest.
Hey, we'll even give you and Molly the employee discount.
Jared, listen, I feel really bad. I know I promised you your job back when you got off your mission. I tell you what, I'm heading to South Africa next month for diamonds.
I usually go, but I have girls' camp.
I wouldn't mind paying you to come along.
To buy diamonds?
Actually, it's to mine diamonds. We get a discount for mining our own. Well, best of luck to you, Jared.
Thanks.
Can't wait for your homecoming.
Don't worry about it. Do you have any idea how many girls asked to marry me before your sister said yes? The sad thing is, I didn't meet her at the Y. In 2 years of that place, nothing.
Who wants a burger?
Those have not been on there long enough.
That's how I like them.
Those hamburgers are completely raw.
That's why we bliss it before we eat it.
Ah, there we are.
I mean it, Jeb. You leave them on.
The thing is, I'm stuck with this ring.
Here's what you do. You place an ad at the bulletin board at the Wilkinson Center. Someone will buy it.
You think so?
Well, it worked for me. A couple times, actually.
Hey, Chair! Look who's here!
What is up, Elder?
Hey, Corey! Oh, man. They sound like nice guys.
Mm-hmm.
A little wild, but nice.
Yeah, they're my frat brothers. One more month, and it's full initiation into the frat.
You, given any more thought to joining the Lord's fraternity and going on a mission?
No, I kind of missed that window.
Are you going to a singles war?
Do dances count?
I doubt it.
So, how's post-mission life treating you?
Oh, not good. My dad left me alone at the store the other day. I totally freaked out. Seriously, they should have an RMTC to tell you how to jump into the real world again.
Oh, man, I heard about Molly. That totally bites.
Well, you know how it is. God works in mysterious ways.
Apparently. So what, you need a new girly friend?
No. No.
Good. That means we can hang together like old times, brother.
Hey, you know what? I could use a job.
What? I thought you were going back to work for Mr.
No?
No? Yeah, I guess all that hard mission labor is really paying off now, huh? I'll tell you what, I can hook you up.
Really?
How's $50 an hour sound?
I just got home from my mission. I'm not going to sell drugs.
Elder, please, let me talk to my boss.
Really? Last mission, happy truth. Last mission, happy truth. As missionaries do.
Sweet. So how's the RM doing?
Good, Bishop.
Hey, it's nice to have you home. I didn't expect you for another month, so our meeting schedule's kind of full, and I may not be able to hear from you for a couple of weeks.
No problem.
I didn't think you'd mind, but it's good to have you home, Elder.
Thanks.
You bet.
Okay, you'd like to welcome you to Elder's Quorum today? Glad to see so many bright faces.
We'll now turn the time over to Sister Cooper for our lesson.
Okay, then. We'll turn the time over to Steve for today's lesson.
No, it's not me today. It's Russ.
No.
Yeah, it is.
No, oh no.
And the spirit will strive among the children of men. Oh, sisters, do you know what that means, the children of men?
All right, let's just dive right in with the lesson. So if you can all open up your manuals to lesson number 9. We haven't done this one yet, have we? Great. Who can read for me the first 6 pages of the lesson? Anybody have a manual?
Thank you, Sister Brian. You'll find the quote on page 17 of my handout. And while you're doing that, I would like to give each one of you a refrigerator magnet to really illustrate the meaning of this quote.
So, nobody's got a manual. Jared, great. Thank you. Take your time.
Excuse me, Steve. Could I borrow Jared for a couple of minutes?
Jared, can you leave your manual, please?
Sure.
Thanks.
Some guys worry more about their great job or their girlfriend, and they put off serving a mission. So I've asked Elder Phelps to come and talk a little bit about some of the blessings that he's received from serving a mission. I spoke with your mom the day after you got back, and she said you already had a great job lined up.
Actually, it didn't work out.
Oh. Well, I understand you had a nice young lady who waited.
No, she's actually engaged to somebody else.
So you don't have a job? And your girlfriend dumped you? Where were you when we had our lesson on Job?
All of our telemarketers, and we don't call them telemarketers, we call them autopilots, because the product virtually sells itself. all of our autopilots, make an average of $50 an hour.
Sale!
A sale! A sale! We got another sale! Hoo-ha!
So, what's the product?
It's the filthy filter. Simply plug it in, turn it on, and turn off those potty mouths.
Sounds easy enough.
Hello, is this Mr. Lampino? My name is Jared. I'm calling about our product. Hello?
All right, then. Okay, hold on, then.
Sale!
A sale! A sale! We got another sale! Hoo-ha!
Hi, my name is Jared. I'm calling about the Filthy Filter. It's a product that filters out the profane... Hello?
Jay, you're doing this all wrong, brother. Let me help you out.
Hi. Hi, Sharon. Corey from the Filthy Filters here. Huh? Yeah, that's us. Listen, Sharon, when I was on my mission, I taught a woman who bought the Filthy Filter, and she said it changed the whole spirit of her home. It's the reason her husband got baptized. Listen, Cher Bear, can you hang on for just two shakes, and we'll get some more information from you. Okay, super. Take care now. Bye-bye.
Say ya!
It simply bleeps out all the profanity. Well, no, it didn't occur to me that some people might actually like the profanity.
My bishop told me it's the best present anyone has ever given him.
What words does it bleep out? Oh, yeah, it would definitely bleep out that word.
Hey, I'm a dad too. That's why I can tell you how important it is.
Whoa. Yeah, that whole phrase would be gone. Not there.
Sail! A sail! We got another sail! Moodle!
So how many sales is that for you?
11.
You're kidding. I haven't even gotten one. Where are you calling?
Provo, Orem, and American Fark.
I'm calling the Bronx.
Dude, you need a filthy filter just to talk to those people.
Hey guys, here's some more hot leads for you.
Panguitch, sweet.
Got any experience?
Sort of.
Sort of?
Well, I just spent 2 years as a missionary.
Sweet, man, I love the way this thing handles.
Yeah, nice and tight, isn't it?
Oh, you better believe it.
Oh, yeah, man. That was awesome, yeah! Woo!
Guess we should have veered left when we veered right.
Oh, yeah, man. Hey, you guys insured?
Fired from your last job?
I only worked there 3 hours.
Oh, sorry.
I don't think that's really enough time to measure someone's performance.
When can you start?
All our merchandise is rent to own. People pay rent on it. After 12 months, they own it.
So what does a rental manager do then?
Well, some people don't pay their rent, and that's when we manage it for them.
I don't want to sleep on the floor!
Back off, kid. Apparently your parents don't care.
We're repossessing their bed?
Listen, it's not their bed until they pay for it. And they haven't been paying.
We got a nursing home next.
Very easy.
What happened to your head?
It's from the little rubber thing at the bottom of a walker.
Wait, you got hit in the head with a walker?
I was under it at the time.
you doing?
Well, I've got a Relief Society lesson this Sunday. I had an idea for the centerpiece. Oh, dinner will be ready in about an hour.
Hey, Jer. Got a letter for you. It's from Mom.
Great. I can finally read about the Tongan sleeping in my room.
You know what? There's this huge singles dance in Logan this weekend. You should come. It's gonna be great. It's at this really nice motel. Package includes dinner, dance, and a room for the night.
No money.
At least come to the dance.
No car.
Well, Dewey and I could take you.
I should have stayed.
What?
My mission. I knew I should have extended.
Jared, I'm sure every RM goes through this.
Yeah, I'm this close to selling knives.
You just need to get out and socialize. Besides, what could go wrong at a dance?
Hello. I'm telling you, the ladies at these things are fine. They're gonna be tons. Relax. Proposed to a girl at one of these ones. Total wacko. Nope, engaged. Kept going on and on about need more time.
How long did you know her?
A couple Donny Osmond songs. You got the ring? This is a singles dance, friend. People don't come here to stay single, okay?
Do what I'm doing.
Beautiful ring for beautiful couple. Hey, what about you guys? Huh?
No, she's my sister.
Yeah, it's not gonna work. Next, head for the mountains. How about you guys? Need a ring?
Got one.
What?
Where's your companion, Elder?
Hey, Corey, what are you doing here?
What, you think we don't like girls or something?
I thought church dances weren't really your scene.
No, I said church was not my scene. But you gotta play both sides of the fence and keep it real. Plus, I got a couple of non-member friends here I'm trying to fellowship. All right, brethren, keep it real, choose the right, and remember who you are and what he stands for. So, anything interesting? Nice. Those are nice.
Those are not sorority girls.
Oh, everybody's got a little sorority in them.
I used to wake up every morning and study my scriptures overlooking the frozen tundra of Greenland. I honestly believe that we must have tracked places that have never seen human eyes.
I was in the sweltering jungles of micro-Indonesia. Once, right in the middle of a discussion, an anaconda grabbed my companion in a chokehold. It's a good thing I carried a machete in my backpack. I saved my comp's life that day.
What about you, Jared?
I went to Evanston, Wyoming, south. We knew a member who had a hoagie yogi. We got free glazies on Wednesdays.
Oh my gosh, how are
Soraya?
You?
Oh my gosh, hi. It's been so long.
I know.
What have you been doing?
Coming.
Oh my gosh, congratulations.
Hey, listen, that's about 3-4 carats, okay, baby?
I'm not dating anyone.
You an Eagle Scout?
Yeah.
You know about that motto? Be prepared. Be getting that checkbook out, okay?
I wanted to go on a mission more than anything, but my doctor wouldn't let me because of my bad back. Sometimes I feel like the whole world is judging me, you know?
That is so wrong.
Excuse me, just 1 minute.
Dude, what is the problem? That girl is totally into me.
You think so?
Look, haven't we always heard God helps those that help themselves?
This is totally different.
Look, tell me something. If that girl was totally fat and ugly, would you tell her?
That's totally different.
Brother, you're back in the real world now. Remember that. Trust me. The Lord's mission is to bring the world.
takers.
Dewey. Dewey, this is Kelly. Kelly, this is my fiance.
Hi, Kelly.
Dewey.
Hi, it's good to meet you.
You too.
Mrs. Jared, my brother.
Hi again.
The airport.
Yeah. Oh, so someone did show up.
It's good to know you made it home.
Speaking of, Kelly's been having some car problems and was wondering if we could follow her back to Salt Lake tomorrow. But Dewey has to work tomorrow morning, so Jared, would you mind staying the night and then we could drive back with her tomorrow?
Yeah, it's not like you have a job to go back to.
I can get you a room with one of the guys from my stake. I know he's not rooming with anyone.
Sure, okay, yeah.
Okay, cool, thanks. Come on, let's go get his room number. So, do you have a girlfriend wait for you?
I did.
You did?
About a year and 11 and a half months.
Ooh, sorry. So, how's home life?
Pretty good, I guess.
Yeah. It's all those blessings from going on a mission.
Yeah.
Can I help you?
Yes. We'd like to get a room.
A number. just a number.
Okay. The name.
That's not fun.
Jared Phelps. Jared Phelps?
You a friend of Kelly's?
Yeah.
Thanks for the bed. I'm just gonna sack out, you know, I'm real tired, so.
Yeah, sure.
Thanks again for the bed.
Yeah, whatever. Salmon. Toothpaste and leave the duck alone.
Jared, you're up. Great. Sleep well?
Not really.
I know, it's so hard to sleep on something besides your own bed. You'll sleep well tonight, though.
Yeah.
Did you forget something?
No, I suffer from companion separation anxiety. I thought I'd be over it by now.
At least you got new shoes.
Yeah, but that's about it as far as everything else goes.
I hear the transition's pretty hard.
It's an understatement.
You must have been a good missionary.
I tried. You know, we really worked hard.
So, how many converts did you have?
Just me.
I get it.
So how many baptisms did you have?
Oh, baptisms. Oh, I gotta tell you about this lady, Sister England.
Why? What did she do?
She was just funny. He wasn't just talking in his sleep. He had Tourette's syndrome in his sleep.
Oh, Jared, I am so sorry. He seemed normal. Sort of. But hey, now you're here with me, and you don't seem to be suffering from post-mission disorder as much.
You know what? I guess I don't.
So the trip wasn't all bad?
How could it have gotten worse?
Now, I apologize about there not being enough room in the cab, but, you know, Piddle, she sure appreciates you letting her keep her seat. Don't you, Piddle? You little squiggy num-nummy. Anyway, about the price for the tow.
Are you two all right?
Now that we're here. Mom, this is Jared Phelps. He was nice enough to ride home with me.
Oh, Jared, hi, Nancy Powers.
Nice to meet you.
Just give me a minute to change and I'll take you home.
Okay. Thanks for the brownie.
Well, thank you for bringing Kelly home.
Are you in school, Jared?
No, but I've applied to BYU, and I just got home from my mission.
Oh, how nice. Where did you go?
Wyoming.
I'm going up there next month.
Oh, really? What is it that you do?
Oh, I'm retired. The trip to Wyoming is church-related.
Oh, why? You work for the church? Huh.
No, Elder Powers is a member of the Second Quorum of 70.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have recognized you. I didn't, though. There are so many general authorities nowadays, and... you know, if we have any more, we're going to need a double fold-out. You know, they'll think that we're looking at swimsuit centerfolds instead of general authorities. And that doesn't sound good.
You ready?
Oh, and then some. Thanks again. Thanks again. Thanks. And... here, kitty. That's all me. My bad. Nice house. I don't even really like swimming suits. Did you guys two-tone this yourselves? 2 years studying the gospel. I can't believe I didn't even know he was a general authority.
Oh, honey, it's okay. There are a lot of them.
H. Ronald Powers called October 3rd, 1998. You gave a talk last session.
Good talk.
Great. Just great. He probably thinks I don't take my religion seriously.
Well, maybe you don't.
Samuel. Now, honey, don't worry about it.
Here, Jared, these came for you. One's from Molly.
Oh, great. I can get dumped all over again. Hey, this one's from BYU.
Our oldest son is going to enter the Lord's University.
Dear Jared Phelps, thank you for your interest in Brigham Young University. Each year, our university receives applications from thousands of the brightest men and women worldwide.
Oh, sweetheart. Ruthie, will you get him a glass of milk?
Okay.
There's always BYU Idaho, son.
Let's see what Molly had to say.
Hello? Yes, how are you? Absolutely. Jared, the stake president wants to meet with you.
Busted.
Jared, thanks for stopping by.
Yep. Hey, president, how are you? Hey, how was that talk by Elder H. Ronald Powers in last October's general conference, huh? Pretty good. Hey, yeah, Elder Powers, he's ordained October 3rd, 1998. He has a beautiful wife named Nancy and a daughter named Kelly. He enjoys... counting things and spending time with his family.
I know Elder Powers very well. And that was a good talk.
Elder's Quorum President? Well, that's wonderful.
How's he doing?
Besides the boils, I think he'll be fine.
Son, it's Dad. It's going to be a great experience.
All the guys in the Quorum are married with kids. And they have jobs. How am I supposed to be a leader to them?
Hey, Jer, can I come in?
Yeah, it's open.
Jared, you were an unbelievable missionary, and you'll make an even better Elders Quorum president.
But Dad, this is just so out of my league. I'm just an RM.
You're not just an RM. You're an LDS RM, who was trained at the MTC, who became a DL, a ZL, and then an AP, who was promised long ago by his bishop through a PPI after BYC that someday he'd be the EQP. I smell GA.
Come on, Dad. It's just... it's not supposed to be like this. I'm not supposed to be Elders Quorum president. I'm supposed to be going to BYU with Molly.
Sometimes life doesn't come together like we planned. And life is like a ball game. A lot of it depends upon the umpire.
It's just, my mission president said I'd be blessed for my service.
And?
And if these are the blessings, then I don't want them. I mean, you didn't go on a mission. Was life this hard for you?
Sure. I wouldn't want it any other way.
I just don't know what I'm supposed to do.
If God called you to be Elders Quorum President, that is what you're supposed to do.
But...
butts are for chairs, pal. Look, have a little faith. You know life's gonna get tougher before it gets easier. But you're a good boy, Jared.
Thanks, Dad. Brethren, I am truly humbled to stand before you today. If men are that they might have joy, then it is truly a blessing for me to be able to serve you. That we as a quorum might have joy together. I'm meeting with each of the elders in the quorum to find out how things are going with their home teaching families. So, how are the Jordans?
The Jordans, yeah. They're real tough to get a hold of.
They're your next door neighbors. Brethren, brand new manuals. Now everyone will have one. Brother Kelson says you haven't been out to see him in 6 months.
Really?
And yet you report 100% home teaching.
Well, that's accumulative, actually. I mean, for the month of January alone, I was there like twice for two of his kids' birthday parties, Super Bowl, dropped my son off for a sleepover, went back, picked him up, and swung by to borrow a plunger. So I'm thinking for a six-month period of time, that'll pretty much cover it. I got to take the plunger back, so I'm pretty much covered for this month.
All right, could I get everybody to open their manuals to lesson 12? And could someone read the opening paragraph? You should all have new manuals. You do have manuals, right?
The Hauser family? Are they on my list?
For the past 2 years. One for you. I'm gonna gather these up so that we'll all have one for next week, okay? There you go.
Will you
visit the Ivies this month?
Will you
visit the Blacks this month?
Will you commit to 100% home teaching this month?
Absolutely.
Yes.
All righty then. Thank you, brethren. Let's open our manuals to page 119. Hey, Brother Tufts, this is Jared. Yeah, hey, I'm just calling to remind you to jot down some comments about the paragraph from the manual. It's the one with Harold Bealey on it. Thanks.
Can I use that
tree? Hey, how's the centerpiece coming?
I think I'm on to something. When does Home Depot close?
9.
Oh, good!
You're just looking good, but...
Hello?
Hello, this is Dr. Gupta down at the Mayo Clinic. We got your test back and it came back positive. You must go boil yourself immediately.
Hey, Corey.
What's up, dude? I got your message. Sorry about your rejection letter.
I'll figure it out.
Dude, let me just say that not getting into BYU is a blessing. That place is nothing but a bunch of bad haircuts and knee-length shorts. When you come over here and see what college life is supposed to be like, you will thank me. You will take that rejection letter out of your little scrapbook and frame it. Come over.
I can't. I gotta go home teaching.
Home teaching. Come over, dude. I'll show you around.
I can't.
What? Dude, ground control to Major Jared. Abort the mission already and come over.
Maybe another time.
Jer, come on. Are we still BFF? Best friends forever?
Yeah.
Then I will see you in 5, bro. Sorry, so sloppy and short. Don't ever change.
I'll see you around. Okay.
That's good. No, indeed. Oh, I love you, man. Excuse me, Master Tucker, Master Reed. This is my friend, Jared.
Mr. BYU. Welcome. I'm Tucker. This here's Reed.
Did you fill us a beer?
No, thanks. I'm riding my bike tonight.
Do you mind if I show him around the place?
Yeah, go check it out.
Make sure you knock, though. You don't want to interrupt anybody studying.
Boom. That's right. Careful.
Okay, that's it, man. They totally like you. I know I can get you in. And once you are in, we are in like Flynn. Hey, man.
Miss October here got us the test key to the big midterm exam.
Nice work, brother.
Thanks.
Need I say more? I'll think about it.
Think about it? Dude, what's there to think about? I totally waited around for you to get back so we could do stuff like this.
I never planned on joining a fraternity.
Yeah, so? I never planned on having a bear on my front porch. That's not the point. Look, I bent over backwards to hook us up here. And now you're... mission or something's changing all that.
What? This has nothing to do with my mission.
I would hope not. Tucker in there, he went on a mission. He's a totally cool guy, right?
Yeah.
So your mission was awesome. You learned a lot of stuff about how the church works. And I stayed here and I learned a ton of stuff about how the real world works. Do yourself a favor and let me show you the ropes. Jared, there's a reason your life sucks right now. You're doing it wrong.
I don't know.
Look, all I'm saying is when you're ready to come home, really come home, lowly Corey might be able to help you out. Nothing's changed, Jer. I'm the same guy you've known your whole life. Remember that.
Welcome to Book of Mormon Burgers. My name is Jared.
Hey.
Kelly.
Hi, Jared.
Hey, it's Ronnie. Elder Powers.
How are you?
Fun place to work, Jared.
Yeah. Love the helmet.
I'm just trying to earn a little extra money for college.
Well, BYU isn't cheap these days.
Yeah. So, what can I get you guys?
I'll have a stripling warrior sandwich. And limoni lemonade, and a side of knee fries.
Make that 2, only change the knee fries to tiancum tots.
Good choice.
I'll just have a shiblam salad and a Waters of Mormon with the lemon, please.
I'll be right back. What if it was an accident?
Nobody leaves their number on accident.
Well, what if she didn't write it?
Hey. You still have the ring.
I had to call.
And then call us right back. Okay, bye.
Right. Commitment pattern.
Hello?
Kelly! Hey, this is Jared.
Do
Do I know you?
Phelps. You're making this harder. Hey, I got your number you left, and that's why I'm calling.
What number?
You mean you didn't leave your number at the restaurant, or?
Oh, that was my mom, yeah. She's been looking for that.
You know, you're killing me. No, seriously, my last dying breath.
I'm sorry.
Kelly, you know, there are a lot of people... You there?
Yeah, I'm here.
There are a lot of people going on dates these days and seeing movies and things. What are your feelings on that?
I love movies.
Golden! All right! Okay, will you commit to me picking you up at about 7 o'clock?
Sure.
Okay, perfect. I'll see you then.
Okay.
Okay. She said yes.
Jared?
Kelly. Just 7, right?
Right.
Okay.
Noah.
As in the Ark or the Wicked King?
The Ark.
My, don't you look handsome.
Thanks. Yeah, I need to borrow the car.
Tough call, sport.
Why?
Unfortunately, you're not on our insurance yet.
You're kidding. I've got a date in like 20 minutes.
Well, I'm sure we can work something out.
I'm sorry for being such a dork on the phone.
Oh, no, you're fine.
I got you this.
A wrist corsage? Wow. I didn't even know they still made these. Oh, it's beautiful. Thank you.
I have to admit, I'm a little nervous. This is my first real date since I've been home from my mission.
Well, just count our car trip home together, and then it'll be your second.
Okay. This is me. I don't have my own car yet.
Hi!
Now, call me when the movie's over.
Okay, Mom.
Do you have change?
Yeah.
Okay, now if you don't, you can't call collect.
I have money, Mom.
Okay. There. Nice to meet you, Kelly.
Oh, you too, Sister Phelps.
Wow, that was uncomfortable.
No, your mom is so nice.
Yeah, she's awesome.
So pregnant.
Yeah, any day now. Other side of Hebrew.
Somebody call 911. There's a lady in a minivan having a baby.
We're taking you right into delivery, Mrs. Phelps.
But I'm supposed to go visiting teaching.
Mom, don't worry about that right now.
Call your father. No, call Sister Martinez first. Tell her I'm sorry.
My dad's on his way. I bet this is the weirdest social experience you've ever heard of.
Actually, the weirdest thing I ever heard of was at a singles dance. This guy asked my friend to marry him after 2 Donny Osmond songs.
Really?
Hi, Ruthie! We heard you got a new member of the family last night.
What is it this time?
It's marshmallows, cornflakes, and gummy worms.
Sounds great.
I'd like to welcome you all here. Mom will be coming home tomorrow afternoon.
So in the interim, I have met with each of these individuals and asked them to take responsibility for the following positions. Jared will vacuum. Soraya and Dewey, all final wedding preparations. Samuel will dust. School lunches, Ruth. Twins as dishwashers. Alma and Amulek as bathroom cleaners. Hopefully Joseph will stay asleep, and Humu will clean out the fridge. All in favor, manifest it. Any opposed, by the same sign.
Surprise!
Thank you very much.
And just in time for the wedding.
Let me see my new grandson.
Whoa, what are we calling him?
Well, we're still working on that. What do you think we should name?
Oh, he's beautiful.
What's your name?
Hello?
Hi, my name's Ricky. I'm calling about the ring.
Oh, great. What kind of warranty do you offer?
I'm not Walmart. You're buying it as is.
What if my fiance doesn't like it?
How could she not like a ring like that?
Yours didn't.
Mine didn't like me.
What about sizing?
Take it to a jewelry store.
Well, if I bought it from a jewelry store, they would size it for free.
Okay, I'll take up $50.
What about the biannual cleaning?
What about the biannual cleaning?
And these prongs can loosen up. What about tightening?
What? This isn't working out. I'm sorry.
Fine, I'll go to utahweddings.com. They have warranties.
Yeah, unless you want your job back.
At least I knew enough to pray about my wife.
Hey, Jared.
Hey! What's going on?
Just got the new Orrin Hatch CD. You're looking good.
Well, thanks. You know, I just got back from Sarai's wedding and having some lunch.
Hey, how's the new job?
Okay. You know, I just got promoted to Nephite Captain.
All right. That's taking the bull by the horns.
So how's your mom and the baby?
Fine. Well, you know, mom and dad are having a hard time picking out the name, though.
Will you tell her we'll drop by later and grab that casserole dish?
Okay.
See you tonight.
Bye.
But Mom, it's not fair. There have been four extra days since 1988.
The extra days in all those leap years do not make a difference.
What do you mean? My birthday should be 4 days earlier.
No matter how many ways you try to cut it, Ruth, you are not dating until you're 16. What on earth happened?
Looks like you've been dumpster diving.
Sweetheart, we need to be at the stake center in 20 minutes. That's an old man's name. Hi, thanks for coming.
You'll get old.
Mom, can I sit down?
No, we're standing in line. Hi.
We've been standing here forever.
But this is your sister's wedding day. Now enjoy this, Samuel, so you'll have something nice to write in your journal. Hi.
Here, Rex, put this on the table.
What is it?
It's a hymn book with their names engraved on it.
Jonah?
No.
How much longer do we have to do this?
Mom, maybe we should sit down.
There are still people coming. We have to stay in line. Hi, thanks so much.
I can't take this anymore.
Samuel Smith, W.W. Phelps, you will stay in line. Hi, thanks so much for coming.
Samuel, are you all right? Speak to me, son.
Father, is that you?
We've got to sit you down someplace.
No, Dad. We need to stay in the line. It's Soraya's wedding.
No more excuses. Come on.
Let's go.
Well, in that case, I could air out.
Trip to the ladies' room would be nice. I'll help you with your training.
Hey.
Let's go.
Hey.
Well, punch anyone?
Hey.
That sounds good.
Guys, we have to hold the line.
performance, son. Very convincing.
Thanks. Thinking about trying out for the road show.
Oh, come on.
Who has the gym?
Hi.
Hi. Hey, is your brother okay?
He is now.
Soraya looks so pretty.
Well, you look great, too.
Thanks.
Lou?
Thanks again for the invitation. It's a gorgeous reception.
Our pleasure. Jared, my brother from another mother. I have a cousin you need to meet.
Okay. I'll be right back.
Sure.
Hey. Jared, this is my cousin Tommy. Let's hear about the ring. You gentlemen do your business, okay?
Here you go. Now, boys, you better hurry so we can get back in line.
Can I call you on Monday?
Sure.
Good.
You can set up a time for me to pick up the ring. Your coat stinks. I'll pay you for the other half.
Yeah.
It was nice meeting you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
What a relief.
Nice. Where are you taking me?
Today's the 31st.
Yeah.
I haven't done my home teaching.
It's not like that's never happened.
I'm Elders Quorum president. I've still got a couple of hours. I gotta go.
Whoa, talk about commitment.
Well, the goal is 100% for the quorum, and I'm a part of the quorum, so...
Okay, you better get out of here.
You're okay?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
These guys great or what? I'd like to dedicate this next song to my beautiful bride. Fellas.
And they called it puppy love. Oh, I guess they'll never know how a young heart really...
Hey, Brother Thompson. Sorry I'm so late. I just wanted to see how you and Sister Thompson were doing. Hey, Sister Thompson. Hey, Brother Hartley couldn't make it, so I'm flying solo tonight. Did I catch you at a bad time? Hi, Brother Miller. I know this is a little unexpected. Well, you guys just let me know if you need anything, and do you mind if we end with a word of prayer? Thanks.
Oh, you know what? I'm fine, but thank you. I'm actually here just real quick to see how things are going.
Come on, Rusty, wake up. It's the home teachers.
Sister Boris? It's Jared Phelps, your new home teacher. Sister Boris, I can see your arm. I brought you a treat. Hey, don't hesitate to call if you need anything, all right? Okay?
Pardon me, but you happen to have in the great prepon.
Corey?
What's up, dude?
Get in, I'll take you wherever you need to go. Great, buddy, thanks.
You just get back from hosting a telethon?
Yeah, Soraya's wedding.
Oh,
dude, will you tell her I'm sorry? I've been totally busy tonight.
whose car?
Is that what's important? No. What's important is it is better a ride than the tandem.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Where to, Rabbi?
Steak Center.
Sweet.
Church is until Sunday, Richard Boy.
This is Candy, and that one is Mandy. They have agreed to accompany me tonight on this evening of indiscretion and ill will.
Are you drinking and driving?
Not at the same time. There's no straw, and the car's not moving.
You know what I mean?
Hey, it's okay. We're not gonna tell your bishop.
It's so
sorry.
That's so funny.
Dude, it's okay. It's not like you can get drunk from that. Let me ring this out.
You know what? You guys are on your own.
Come on. Chair.
Hey!
Car.
Okay, I'm driving.
Whoa. Yeah, I think we might be a little safer with me driving.
This is a lot bigger than a bike.
Not your bike, no. Have you guys ever seen a tandem bike?
I'm sure you're aware of the whole open alcohol in the car thing, right?
I am now. Girls, unload the evidence.
Break it off, Casanova.
Whew, I'm getting a buzz off your fumes, man. Are you having a party in that shirt?
All right, lady.
This is breaking news on ABC4.
We have a breaking story just into the ABC4 newsroom. Police are telling us two men created quite a scene tonight at a local wedding reception when they tried unsuccessfully to crash the party.
Jared Phelps and Corey Swenson, both seen here, were arrested on multiple charges of public intoxication, driving under the influence, and suspicion of stealing the governor's car. That and littering.
If those were my kids, I'd kill them.
Yeah, no kidding.
You make it sound so bad.
It is so bad.
What? This is nothing.
Wait, you haven't looked around? We're sitting in a jail cell.
So? What's the worst thing that could happen?
Hey, boy. Hey. Pretty boy.
Time is a ticking. Are you listening? When you find out what you're missing.
They leave us in a jail cell.
Dude, relax. Look, we'll make something up. I will do all the talk.
Make something up to a judge?
What is the difference?
The difference is it's lying. At some point, you better figure that out and write it down or something. Can you write, Mr. Ryder, now?
Well, Mr. Phelps, your testimony seems to match that of Mr. Spencer's. So I'm reducing the charge to just littering.
Congratulations, Jared. Good job.
Thanks.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Boys.
Those are the hardest kind of decisions to make, son. There's a fine line between the spirit of the law and the letter of the law.
I know.
Well, if you feel like you've made the right decision, we're behind you all the way.
Thanks, Dad.
You're good boys.
Thanks, Brother Phelps.
See, Jared?
Your dad's right. Didn't I tell you everything would work out just fine?
You liar! I told you I'd hunt you down!
Tell Kelly.
What?
Tell Kelly.
What?
Tell Kelly. I'm gonna die a martyr.
I doubt it. Come on, man. Bail's been posted.
Bishop Andrews called. Given the circumstances, he feels it would be best that you not give your homecoming talk this Sunday.
Mom, Dad, I am really sorry about all of this.
We know that you didn't get the homecoming that you wanted. And with the baby and Soraya's wedding, well, there's been a lot of attention focused elsewhere.
Mom, please get
Jay. Where did we go wrong?
Mom, wait. Dad.
I guess you have a few days to figure things out.
Mom knows I'm innocent, right? Thought you could use this. I'm being released?
The stake presidency feels that the legal problem facing you may create a negative challenge for your calling. It's probably for the best.
But I finally got all the guys to bring their manuals.
Oh, Jared, a guy named Tommy called about the ring.
There's some good news.
Not exactly. He said the deal's off. He was afraid it was stolen.
Perfect. Anything else?
Your work called. They said you were fired for not showing up.
I was being arrested!
They must not consider felony arrest an excusable cause for time off. Sorry.
You still love me, don't you, buddy?
Why don't you go back? I know you wouldn't hurt any more than when you left. Then you would not have to be alone anymore. You only fool you. You say you're happy. Whoopity-doo. You know that's not true. To you're playing the fool. Go back, go. So you say it's whack. So in the memories won't erase.
Hey.
Boys.
How you doing?
I'm great.
Good.
The Alumni Association has asked me to step in, as the fraternity feels somewhat responsible to Corey since this was an initiation prank. Now, as defense for both of you, let me tell you how this is going to play out. The governor is going to press charges, simply because his car is stolen this time every year, presumably by our fraternity. However, I'm acquainted with the judge, and due to his full docket, he's willing to throw this case out if we can present a plausible story. Okay, so here's how the story's going to play out. Please follow along, as I will move very quickly. We start out at your sister's reception, where you and Corey were valet partying.
At a Mormon wedding?
In this case, yes.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
I'm a lawyer, not an astronaut. Can I continue? Thank you. All right, your parents asked the Boy Scouts to valet park, but when it got busy, they asked for your and Corey's help.
Okay, Corey wasn't even there.
Huh, well, I have a wedding announcement addressed to him that says he was.
Okay, what about the girls?
Well, the girls were taking the fifth. In layman's terms, they were too drunk to remember anything.
You want me to lie to a judge?
It's not a lie, all right?
Okay, what would you call it then?
A minor indiscretion the judge is willing to overlook, especially since this is a first-time offense for both of you.
Come on, Chair. It's not like we're criminals or something.
I can't lie.
Let me be clear about this, Chair. Be assured the fraternity is not going to take the heat for you simply because you want to make a moral point. Okay, we're nationally affiliated and we do not need the exposure. Let me remind you that you were the one driving the car. For all we know, you were the one who stole the car.
Actually,
all right, think of all the witnesses. Posed another way, if you fold, we'll be forced to testify against you. Oh, you'll say goodbye for another couple years, and you'll be in a suit, just a different color.
All arise.
You may be seated. Bailiff.
My mother made it, Your Honor.
Counsel, your first witness.
Jared Phelps to the stand.
Ladies and gentlemen of the court, what you are about to hear is a fantastically sordid tale of mystery and intrigue, smattered with stolen vehicles and car parking Boy Scouts and gun-toting midgets.
Counsel, I've got a pretty full agenda. Can we dispense with the theatrics?
Thank you, Your Honor. Mr. Phelps, were you, or were you not, found driving the governor's stolen vehicle on the night in question? Simple yes or no answer.
Mr. Phelps, I'd like to move through this as quickly as possible.
Your Honor, it's just like our statement read. We were asked by the scouts to valet park, and someone had already stolen and partied in the car. We were just parking it.
Thank you, Mr. Phelps. Your testimony certainly agrees with the statement that was presented earlier, so I'm reducing all charges to littering.
Sorry we underestimated you. Welcome to the fraternity. If you're interested, we'd love to have you.
I don't know.
Yeah. He's totally one of us now. Come on, man. Let's go get some food. I got some girls I want you to meet.
Mr. Phelps, I'd like to move through this as quick as possible.
Yes. Yes, I was driving the car.
And is it your claim that you were asked to valet park the 2002 Lincoln Town Car, standard package, no options?
No.
And who were these mysterious visitors who appeared out of nowhere and asked you to valet park said car, huh?
Counsel, I think it was made abundantly clear that the defendant said no.
And that's what I thought. One moment, confer.
Yes, he was driving the car. No, he wasn't asked to valet it. What do we have next? Oh, the end of drinking the drink.
I want to be your friend. I am here to understand you. That's why I'm here as an officer of the court. But I need to understand one thing, Mr. Pillsbury. I don't understand the irresponsible consumption of enormous amounts of alcoholic beverage while driving. Can you explain that consumption?
No, I can't explain it. There was drinking going on, and that's...
All right, your friend's folding. You better save this.
I'll take care of it.
Your Honor, Jared isn't really explaining what happened that night.
I object! You, out of order! This whole system is out of order! I don't think the court will allow, nor these good people, for you to stand there and try to explain your way out of this one.
Just a minute, counsel.
Yes, great idea.
Just exactly what did happen, Mr. Svensson?
Jared was... He was home teaching.
At 11 o'clock at night?
It was the end of the month.
We picked him up after grabbing some beer.
Where did you get the car?
We sort of borrowed, lent, stole it. But it wasn't really stealing, because we had the governor's niece with us and her friend. She was totally hot. And they gave us the keys, so that's not really stealing, is it?
I know there's at least one person in this room that thanks you for your honesty. You may have saved a friend from having to go to jail on counts that he's not guilty of. What I'm saying, Mr. Svensson, is you will spend time in jail to give you a chance to think about not wanting to do this again. What may have seemed like a harmless fraternity prank is considered grand theft auto in my courtroom, and driving under the influence adds substantially to the offense. However, because this is a first-time offense and a prank, the fraternity should share some guilt in. I think that the court can find some amount of leniency in its sentencing. Bailiff, please admit Mr. Svensson to the court for booking. Court dismissed.
The old night.
You're free to go, Mr. Phelps.
Get away from me, kid. You bug me.
You have fun looking.
Ah! If you have some time and would like to quadruple your income, my wife and I are having a little meeting over at the house this evening.
Jared, I knew everything would work out, but I wavered when you needed me most. Can you ever forgive me?
Mom, relax. You're the best. I love you.
You should be so proud to be the brother of Jared. That's it. Brigham, I've got it.
I guess in some ways we've been planning this our whole lives, huh? And here we are. From the time you were two and I was three, you were always the example. What are best friends for?
Look, you'll be out in no time.
Yeah. Will you wait for me?
Scout's honor. Godspeed, brother.
All right, ladies, it's time to go. Skip it for visiting now.
Will I wait for you?
You guys are making me sick.
And in closing, I'd just like to let you know that I learned a lot of things on my mission, and even more since I've been home, it seems. My mission president said I'd be blessed for my service. And I guess in a lot of ways I have been.
I'd like to bear my testimony in my native tongue of Wyoming.
Jerry, you did a great job on your talk. Why don't you give me a call sometime?
Okay. Thanks. Wonderful talk, Jared.
Oh, hey, thanks. It's great to finally have it finished.
Oh, you did a great job. Hey, Jared, not to defile the Sabbath, but I'm heading to Africa next week for diamonds. I could sure use your help.
Oh, thanks for the offer, but you know what? I'm actually going to be starting some night classes to see if I can get into the Y this fall. But you know what? I met this guy named Ricky a while back, and he, I think he'd be really interested.
Oh, that'd be great. You know, I think he'd love it. It's kind of like a treasure hunt.
It is.
In fact, it is a treasure hunt.
Sounds like fun. Hey, would you guys excuse me for a minute?
Sure. Sure.
Seen you around.
Yeah, I went to Wyoming with my dad for a week. Home teaching, huh?
Yeah, I guess I better get it done a little earlier next month.
Yeah, I think that would be best.
Kelly, I'm gonna need some time.
Oh. Wait. I understand. You're killing me.
I've been there.
So who are the girls anyway?
Potential investigators.
Ready, set, go!
How about an exchange? You sure she's gonna say yes this time?
She already has.
This must be the lucky young lady.
Hi, Kelly Powers.
Kelly Powers? You aren't related to H. Ronald Powers, are you?
It's my dad.
Great talk last October.
Your fiancé is hot.
You speak English?
Better than Tongan, actually.
But my mom said that you just spoke Tongan.
No offense, man. All your mom ever talks about is baked goods and Relief Society centerpieces. In order to avoid an awkward conversation, I had to eat. Heck, I was $1.80 when I first got here.
Give, oh give, give, oh give. singing as it fell upon the flower. Singing, singing all the day. Give away, oh, give away. Singing, singing all the day. Give, oh, give away. Give then as Jesus gives. Give, oh, give, give, oh, give, give then as Jesus gives. There is something all can give. Do as the streams and the blossoms.